Hello there everybody and welcome to Lab Facts. Lab Facts refers to Lepidoptera facts and is a short YouTube series where I tell you one fun fact about butterflies or moths each time. And here's the fun fact of the day. Did you know that the lifespan of the imagos, that means the adults, of many butterflies and moths is very limited because of their dietary habits? That's right. First of all, many types of moths are born without a mouth, without functioning mouth parts. This means they are literally unable to eat and forced to starve to death. That all sounds rather grim, but as you know, many types of butterflies and moths do have functioning mouth parts. And some people call this a tongue, although this is incorrect. It's actually called a proboscis, but okay. Let's not get into semantics too deeply. And this works almost like a hollow tube or a straw that can suck up food in liquid form. And as you know, many butterflies and moths use it to visit flowers and access the sugary nectar from these flowers. And they suck it up by extending this tongue into the flower. However, in some cases, butterflies and moths also use it to drink fruit juice from fallen and fermenting fruits, and in some cases also tree sap from wounded and bleeding trees, which is also quite sugary, mildew from certain types of aphids that secrete sugary substances, and some males use it to suck up mineral rich liquids such as water from streams, but also animal carcasses and feces. However, there is one big problem with this. Imagine if you had to live on a diet of nectar or fruit juice. If you look at the contents of basically this food, you will notice that most of it is just sugary water. And to butterflies and moths, it's almost like living off a diet that only consists of energy drinks. Sure, it's a great boost in energy, but there's one big problem. These butterflies and moths, they do not have any food source that has any type of nutritional value. They do not get any type of proteins. And these substances are essential. Proteins and amino acids, etc., are used to replenish cells and tissues in their body, and basically they do not consume any substances with nutritional value. And this is why many butterflies and moths only live for a short time. You see, by drinking nectar and fruit juice and whatever else, kind of sweet liquids they can find, they are basically limiting themselves to living off a diet of energy drinks, as to oversimplify it. And because of this, their bodies age rapidly because they cannot form new cells or repair body tissue, and over time their body slowly dies because of this process. Every cell that dies is hardly replaced. But there is one type of butterfly that has overcome this problem. In some parts of North and South America, you have butterflies from the genus Heliconius, also referred to as long wings, passion fruit butterflies, or postmen. And some of you may know the zebra long wing. I believe the scientific name is, I think it forgot it for a second, but if you live in Florida or maybe the Caribbean or parts of Central and South America, you may have seen it. But there's also other many species that some of you are familiar with. Heliconius charitonius or Heliconius sara. Anyways, let's get to the point. These butterflies have an adaptation that can make them grow much older than normal, typical butterfly. And this is because they can use their proboscis, their tongue, their mouth parts, to secrete a digestive enzyme. Now, the trick is, when they visit flowers, okay, to drink up the nectar, the enzyme they secrete, it can actually dissolve the pollen of the flower. And by dissolving the pollen of the flower, it becomes liquid. And in liquid form, they are able to suck it up and consume it. And this has given them access to basically a sort of nutrition that most butterflies and moths lack completely in their diet. They are able to consume proteins, amino acids from the pollen that other butterflies do not get from just drinking nectar. And for this reason, these butterflies are reported to live up to 9 or 10 months time without overwintering, which is impressive because most butterflies and moths only live for a few months only. Some of them just for a few weeks. And all of this just because these Heliconius butterflies have an evolutionary adaptation that allows them to grow old. Now, it's not surprising that this is a rare trait, because some of you may say or think to yourselves, why do butterflies and moths have such a limited lifespan, and why are there not more species that have come up to solutions to this problem? Well, the reason is because there is little need to. Not always is having a longer lifespan an advantage for an insect, okay? The biology of butterflies and moths works that way, works in such a way that they basically procreate in a short time, but very efficiently and in high numbers. So there is not much evolutionary pressure for extending their lifespans. It doesn't give them a big advantage, which is why this sort of adaptation is generally very rare. As a general rule, if you are able to reproduce yourself in a few weeks' time efficiently, there's no need to prolong your lifespan and do the same thing in a longer amount of time. Unless perhaps you can use this longer time lifespan to propagate yourself maybe more times, or make more use of your time, but this doesn't happen with insects that have a high rate of predation and mortality. So this is generally selected against. Now, these Heliconius butterflies, many of them are toxic and have aposematic colors and are generally left alone by predators. And this could be one of the reasons that perhaps their mortality and lifespan do not interfere with each other, because they are left alone and face a lower rate of mortality as adults. And thus, the payoff of living for a longer time may perhaps be worth it, but I'm not entirely sure. This was the fun fact of the day. Thanks for watching.